Good morning, student. Today is Monday, 20th July 2020. You are welcome in the class Physics 10th OLA. Today we are going to start new unit, that is 20, and its name is Magnetism. And the few things we will learn, that introduction means its discovery, then the chemical name, formula, and some magnetic material. Magnetism. It means that we will study here about the magnet and its some properties. Its working, its use in different field of life. That is called magnetism. Magnet and its property, its use in different phenomena of our daily life. That called magnetism. Introduction means discovery. Chinese claims that round about 4,000 years back, they discovered it. You may have heard the story in your junior classes, that how it was discovered, but after while it was discovered, firstly they used for the navigation. In their language it is called lodestone. Lode in their language have the same meaning as that of lead stone. Lead mean to guide. Why they use this magnet to guide the direction? Because when we hang a small piece of magnet with a thread and we hang it in air, it automatically aligns it in two directions. One is north and the other is south. So in ancient time and today also, the magnetic compass that is made out of magnet are being used to guide the direction, particularly in the sea. The ship use it for the navigation purpose, particularly when it is night or the broad sea and there are the clouds. In the daytime they can't see the direction of the sun, so they use this one, the compass, magnetic compass. And in ancient time they have been using, even just they try hang up it in air with the thread, and its natural property that it aligns it itself in two direction, north and south. It is also the its property. Now what is the chemical name? Chemical name is ferrite and its formula that is Fe2O4. In somewhere I saw that Fe2 and O3, so you might confirm it because it is a matter of chemistry. So anywho, you can confirm from the different sources, you can find it from the net also. Before I saw that it is Fe2O3, and again I tried to look it there, so I saw again that it is Fe2O4. Anywho, its name is iron oxide. Now the magnetic material. What the magnetic material, the materials which are being affected by the magnet, these are called magnetic material. Suppose these are three: nickel, cobalt, and iron. Steel also. So these three are four materials. Mostly we use iron to magnetize, because it is soft as compared to the other material and it can easily magnetize. So magnet materials are those materials which are being affected, which are being used to magnetize silver, bronze and tin. They cannot be magnetized. So magnet material mean that they are affected by the magnet, and they acquire, in the presence of the magnet, they acquire the same property of the magnet. What are the property? Attraction and repulsion, and having two poles, north and south pole. So these material, magnetic materials, are those material which are being affected by the magnet, which are used to magnetize. They can easily magnetize, and when they are magnetized, they acquire the same properties as that of the magnet. And the magnet properties: attraction, repulsion, and having two poles. Same pole, they repel each other. Opposite pole, attract each other. So these are the properties of the magnet. While these materials are magnetized, they acquire the same properties as that of the magnet. Moreover, the second property, that magnet, natural magnet, have the two poles. Likewise, the magnetic material, when they are magnetized, they acquire the same properties, that attraction, repulsion, and also they align themselves in a free as that in a direction of north and pole. So they acquire the property of being north and pole. So thank you, boys. Today we end up our lecture. Have a nice day, and God bless you again. Hopefully tomorrow we will meet each other again. Thank you, and God bless.